Assalamu alaikum guys. Today in this practical video, I will show you the big mistakes in the construction of this cantilever beam. Guys, you can see the length of this cantilever beam is 7 feet. On the other side, you can see this is simply supported beam because this is one column and that is other column. So therefore, this is simply supported beam and this is cantilever beam. Guys, you can see here, the depth of this cantilever beam is 18 inches and its width is 12 inches. At the bottom layer, which is compression zone in this cantilever beam, because this is the opposite of simply supported beam. At the bottom, we have three steel rods. At the top, we have also three steel rods. Dia is same, which is 16 millimeter. We have also side bars. On each side, we have one steel rod. Dia is 12 millimeter. This is stirrup, dia is 10 millimeter. Spacing you can see 6 to 7 inches. Hooks are bent with 90 degree, not provided on 135 degree. So guys, everything is wrong in this construction of cantilever beam. Guys, you can see clearly spacing of stirrups, hooks, bottom bars, top bars. This is fixed end. You can see, guys. The first stirrups should be placed with the distance of minimum 2 inches. But this is about 6 inches. This is 7 inches. Guys, you can see. You will find a lot of mistake in this cantilever beam construction. Remember, guys, in cantilever beam, the top portion is called tension zone and the bottom portion is called compression zone. So this is the opposite of simply supported beam. Compared to bottom zone, we should provide maximum numbers at the top zone because concrete is strong in compression and steel is strong in tension. So therefore, concrete is weak in tension. So we will provide more steel rods at the top zone, especially in cantilever beam. At the bottom, you will use minimum steel rods compared to its top portion. But they did not provide it here proper designing in this cantilever beam because they don't know about steel structural design for commercial building or domestic building. So they are just wasting the time as well as they are wasting their money. So guys, why I'm showing you these kind of mistakes? Because if you are working on construction site, so these kind of construction can help you. So you should avoid these kind of mistakes if you are working on site. Guys, you can see this is the other cantilever beam. Design is same. Also, in top portion, they should provide development length. In cantilever beam, at the bottom portion, they should not provide development length, but at the top they should provide development length. It should be minimum 9 to 9 inches, but the proper length is 12 inches. And free end, they should provide minimum spacing of stirrups. Guys, you can see this is the other cantilever beam. They sit in the shuttering already. You can see the lapping length and the slab. So where we have maximum chances for failure, so here they provided lapping length on the top of this cantilever beam. So this is the other mistake. So in this construction of commercial building, you will see more mistakes. Guys, you can see this is simply supported beam. Also, this is not the proper design. Everything is wrong, guys. So be careful for cantilever beam, simply supported beam, because this kind of project is very heavy mega project. So this is about four to five story. So therefore, they should not do these kind of mistakes because they should use the proper steel structural design. They should have a site supervisor for the proper supervision. Actually, these kind of design for the local area, the steel fixer, actually this the steel fixers are their steel structural designer. So therefore they are doing these kind of mistakes which I'm showing you in this video. Remember guys, these kind of projects are millions of projects. So therefore you should keep a site engineer, a structural engineer, a site supervisor to give you more benefits, especially for steel structural design. Just for minimum amount they are doing this kind of job. Guys, you can see this is the junction beam and column and fixed end for this cantilever beam. So they did not provide any extra steel rods to resist negative bending moment. Stirrups are provided closely to resist shear stresses. Guys, you can see it's shuttering. Everything is wrong. Hope this video can help you. So if you are working on construction site, so this kind of video can help you. Thank you.